Hey guys, my name is John and I am a teacher at Heartland International English School. So basically I just want to give you a bunch of tips to help you with your online learning. Online has a big disadvantage and a big advantage at the same time, and that is that you have a lot of control over your learning when you're online, right? So I think the major thing is it really requires you to be kind of conscientious and just pay attention to how you learn. Without having a teacher watching everything you do, it's a little bit easier to distract yourself or to speak in your native tongue. So I think it's important while we're online to kind of be, try to be focused, try to be engaged, and try your best to remember that English only policy that Heartland has. There's a good reason for it. And so if you can stick to English a little bit, even while you're talking to your housemates or even while you're watching YouTube or videos or whatever, I think it's going to benefit you a lot in the long run. The other tip is that I know burnout is a thing. Basically, people focusing on the computer all day, it can be a little tough. So, you don't have to get away completely from your English practice. You can just do practice in a new environment. Watch English movies, watch English clips, read an English book. Doing this stuff, getting outside your comfort zone and not necessarily just staring at a computer all day is stuff that will help your English practice as well. I think also just making sure that you have a little bit of a routine and that you review your stuff at the end of the day, just like you were in a school, just like you were in a classroom, and just kind of pushing yourself a little bit to study can help you too. I think when you're home all day, it can be a little bit easy to distract and to get a little bit lazy. This is true for me for sure. So that extra little push can help you as well. I actually really recommend doing exercises and doing your writing once in a while with a pen and paper, because I think when you do something with your hand, it's kind of a ritual, and that physicality has a special connection to your mind in a way that just typing doesn't always. So I think sometimes it can be good to put away the electronics and just try doing things by hand, reading or journaling or writing down vocabulary, sentences, stuff like that. So that's it for me. I hope everybody's enjoying these times and finding things to do and finding other ways to socialize with their friends and their family and staying healthy, of course, most important of all. So we'll see you later. I hope you guys have an awesome week.